Alright, I am playing Shroud of the Avatar R23 again, except with some subtle differences. You may notice it's not my usual character name. And that is because I purchased a second copy of the game on my alt account while it was on sale this weekend, so that I can mess around with things like character creation. So I've been experimenting with how all this stuff works. So this is like the earlier Ultimas in that it asks you three or four questions, in fact, and you can answer in three ways to several of them, well, mostly two ways. And what you answer most for determines your initial character alignment and style. So I'm going to pick for this playthrough truth. Can't pick truth there though, so I'll have to pick love, and then I'll pick truth. And yeah, she finishes talking to me. You can actually see it on the other tab. And says farewell, and we'll dash off to the portal and we'll see what's going on. So my plan for this video is I'm going to go through and create one of each of the three types of character, visit each of the starting areas, and just basically have a run around the starting area, show you what they're like, show you where things are, and then perhaps I'll finish off by doing some of the initial quests on the love quest line, which is the default one in Solace Bridge. So this one, I think, is currently the most interesting starting area, this Blood River Massacre. So you get this if you pick truth, and if you pick truth, you end up with a little bit of combat, a little bit of combat skill, and quite a lot of fiery death skill going on. So you got any death? Yeah, there we go, we got some death stuff. You're basically a fire mage, although you don't have any particular affinities to what was going on. You know, the affinities are where you, as you become good in one thing, you become less good in the other thing. So there are a lot of dead bodies lying around, and if you look at them, they have some interesting stories to tell. So let's read this mustering notice. I'm not going to read it out right now. I'll leave it here. You pause the video if you want to read it. But there are these little notes that explain how this massacre came about and the background of stuff that's going on. It's quite interesting. This is obviously all part of the plot line, the truth storyline that you'll be able to get. So I'm going to take the gold and let's have a look at this bloke. Take his gold as well. There we go, looted some gold. So to carry on, there's a sword here on the sword rack. Pick it up, so I've equipped that. I'm not going to loot any more bodies for now. I recommend if you are playing through this, the huge number of dead bodies lying around is quite handy for building your initial set of resources. You do get some stuff. Well, we've got some reagents, we've got some maps, we've got some health potions and focus potions, some repair kits. But yeah, gold will always come in handy. The elves won't have any gold on them. If we look, elves not into gold. Humans will have gold on them. Right, so anyway, let's do the story. Let's talk to the scavenger bloke. So he'll tell you, he'll tell you some stuff. The key thing to hit with him is salvage. And he says he has this odd little dagger. You write it in your journal. Some incredible messcraft, blah blah blah. Offer something better. And we're not offering anything better at this moment. So the way to escape this scene is to find something better to offer the scavenger. And I'll just nip down this way to show you what happened. We'll stop and read this note. So this note is written by an elf. It basically indicates the difficulty the elves are having in understanding how the human mind works, and hard to predict when humans attack. They don't show their teeth or keep the tail stiff. Many children died. I don't see all my children had to die. So elves feeling a bit hard done by here. Having been viciously attacked by humans. And, lying massacred. As if by magic, a bard will appear. He's wandering over there. So this is the gate. It's the way out. You can't open that gate in this scene. Oh, the bard has appeared. There we go. Edvard. Edvard the Wanderer. So you have to tell me your name. I'm sure I typed it a minute ago. There we go. Fingers. Bargains. Offer. So basically what we want to do, he's explaining to you here what I just told you. You need to get something to offer to the looter up there. So I'm just going to head this way for now, just to give you a lay of the land. You can see the escape portal over there, but you can't get to it through all the fire. If you go down here, yep, there's another note. We hear about the elven fisherman trying to understand this thing called literature, where humans write down lies and tell lies to each other. And he's struggling to get his head around it. These sacks often have resources in, if you're looking for them. Not in here, though. There are quite a lot of starter resources if you wander around the whole area. It's quite well stocked with stuff that will come in handy, crafting materials. We'll just nip up here to the barn. You can go in all the other houses, you can go in. I'm just going up here because I know there's another note up here. And here we have the farmer. Talking about the land being fertile, building some trade with humans. And it's confusion when they keep trying to offer him gold so that they can then use the gold to buy things. He doesn't understand why they can't just barter the things they have for the things they need and get on with it. So anyway, enough of the backstory. Well, there'll be a little bit more backstory because I like it. So imagine here we're back at the scavenger. So where you need to go at this point is up this road, and you this house is quite interesting because this is the lawkeeper's house. It's got I recommend you go in there and read all the notes. I'll not waste time doing it now. We need to go in this house because this house has within it a cat, and cats are important. So once you found the house with a cat in it, you find the chest of drawers with a note on it, with a nice song about a cat, which the elf is very, very pleased with. It teaches others many things about cats that I have learned. I sang it to the cat we share our home with, and it raised its tail in approval as well. I will continue to work on this, although unfortunately he doesn't get to continue on his cat story. But in the chest of drawers underneath is an intricate elven mirror. And we'll head back to the looting guy. Just over this way. There he is. Double click to chat, find something better. Scavenger is looking for intricate elven mirror. There he is. Go for it. Give items. Write it in my journal. Oh, thank you for your patronage, good sir. Yeah, not the smartest cookie. So having attained the knife, you can now go and find Edvard again. He's wandering around here. Hello, Edvard. Dagger. And yeah, he does actually reply. Although you don't get to see it, it's a bit of a weird bug. He gives you some stuff to give to Stanley in Soul Town, and then he'll say, unlock the gate. Good luck with your quest for truth. Now, of course, the quest for truth past this bit isn't yet implemented. All that's implemented is the quest for love, which is like the standard starting quest line. So we're just going to go out here, kill these wolves. Where is he? There he is. And I'm going to give him some of that. I'm going to give him a fireball. I'm leveling up in stuff. I'm going to set fire to my sword, because why not? Let's heal me up a bit. Alright, we've killed the wolf. I'll not stop to loot him. I'm going to delete this character in a minute anyway. Let's set fire to the next one. There you are. Let's set fire to my weapon again. There we go. That wolf dead as well. Yep. Him on fire. I'm leveling up in stuff all the time. Wolf is dead. Alright, so after you've defeated the wolves, although you actually, technically you don't have to defeat the wolves, you can just run past them. But, you know, after you've defeated them or run away from them, you head over to the portal here. I imagine when the actual plotline's finished, you'll run out of the area and go up the road there. There is across the way a camp where the attackers set up, I think. And this will take you to Soul Town, which actually puts you back on the love quest. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Soul Town now, and then I'll cut the video here. So I enter the Soul Town. I'll delete this character, start a new one, and we will do the Courage plotline. Alright, I'm back on the Isle of Storms with a newly created character. Let's talk to Arabella again. Let's hide the hints, because I've seen them before. Guide, Destiny. Ready to begin. Right. So this time I'm going to mostly answer courage. I can't answer courage for the first question, so we'll go for love. Courage for the second question. And we'll go for truth just now for the third question, just to demonstrate that you then get a fourth question, which you don't do if you've picked two of the same for the first three questions. But anyway, we'll answer courage, and that will set us on our path, and we'll lag it round to the rift. So with courage, courage creates a paladin style character. You're a soldier anyway. You get a sword. You have mostly sword skills. We'll get into the starting scene and review them. Here we go. So the Battle of Highvale. This is the second starting scene. Oh, the second new one in the R23 release, anyway. So we're here, let's just have a quick look at the skills. So we get a lot of blade stuff. We get 10 in other weapons. We get heavy armor stuff. Nothing in light armor. 10 in pole arms. Nothing. Oh, yeah, we do get some range. Nothing in shield. And we get a little bit of magic in fire, life, which everyone gets, sun, which everyone gets, nothing in water. Again, no affinities are chosen for you, so you still got the option of doing that later. We get nothing in focus or subterfuge, but we do get strength related starting skills. So let's investigate this scene a bit. Yeah. You come into the aftermath of a battle. There's a dying knight on the ground who you converse with. As per the other things, you have to tell me. I don't know if what happens if you lie to them. But I'm guessing, well, certainly nothing this at this point. Maybe this will be how you set your name rather than the character creation. I don't know. So I've received 4 things from the dying knight. Which is all I really need at this point. Goodbye, dying knight. So now we have to head down to the village. Now I suspect this scene is the one you most likely die on at the first attempt if you miss the stairs on the way down. It's quite a long drop. So there is stuff. It's a fairly large scene for you to go exploring in, but where you need to go first is here to this training ground and grab a sword. As in the other scenes, you can then wail on the practice dummy, whatever. Let's try a bit of that. There we go. Enough practicing. There are, as you see, many dead bodies lying around. Again, if you're playing this for real, it's probably worth checking all the dead bodies, build up some gold. Otherwise, hard to come by. Let's speak to the bard. Ah, he realizes we're not Tracy. We are the Avatar. Right. The gate. He doesn't know anything about the gate. But what we do need to do is discover Tracy, the guard captain, who's actually lying up here. Oopsie, there we go. This is Tracy, the guard captain. Before we do that, let's just nip up the steps here, have a quick look around. There's a house here we can go into. There we go. There's a book. The Weasel in the Granary. Nice little poem. There is plenty of stuff around these houses to loot. Not in this one, evidently. But you can, if you have a look around, dig in the cupboards, I recommend you do that. You will find various useful bits and pieces. There isn't as much story to find here as with the... there we go, identification papers. And the gate key. That's what we need. There isn't as much story to find here as what there is... In the last scene I was looking at, the Blood River one. I've not seen nearly so many notes and stuff lying around. However, there is If you look around, where's he gone? If you look around this way, there is a there he is, a healer who will tell you some things about the battle and the elves and Resolute. That's just north of here. So we'll say goodbye to him. There are a few knights in the houses. I'm not going to look around them now. We're going to head to the gate. And because we've got a key, that means we can lift that heavy thing off. Outside we'll find some nasty elves. Elf patroller. So let's set ourselves in auto attack mode and go do him in. There we go. Alright, we've done him in. Let's have at him. Here we go. Cool. This one wants to run away from us and use his boat. Which is always a bit annoying. Come back, you. Missed him. Missed him again. Still missing him. Ah, we got him in the rend at last. Ah, there we go. When you finally hit him, you get him good and proper. So I've leveled up a bit. So, in the rest of the scene here, there is some. There is an elven camp up the road, which you can investigate. For some clues as to what's going on. It's over that way. You can see the tents in the distance. But you exit this scene by just running along the road here. Up the hill. And there's a gate at the top. And you once again end up in Soul Town. So again, the rest of the Courage plotline isn't in yet. It's just this bit of it. So once you've done this scene, you're back on the love plotline, which is what I'm going to do next with the ranger type character, and then do the opening few missions. Right. I'll just exit this and back again with a brand new character in a few seconds. Okay, here we are once again in the Isle of Storms with a mysterious woman called Arabella. Let's turn off the hints one more time. Guide, destiny, ready to begin. Right, so this time we're going to go for love. Like so. I'll show love again. I'll show courage. So, our destiny is set. We are on the path of love, which will give us a ranger type character with a bow and an arrow and that sort of malarkey. If you watched my first look video, that was exactly the type of character I created by accident because I had no clue what I was doing. Now that I'm wise in the ways of R23, I'm doing it purposefully. Because I've got this new account, which I've created and deleted the character multiple times, I can also get around the main weakness of the ranger's starting character, is being the limited amount of ammo. you have available. Alright then. Yes, I need a weapon. So here we are in the familiar by now Solace Bridge. I'm gonna go and get the arrow. Sorry, get the boat. I'm gonna get the boat, come on. I've got the boat, right. Let's quickly review the skills we get. We do get starting 10 bladed combat. We don't get a bladed weapon. Nothing in heavy armour. We get some light armour stuff. Range, we've got a whole load of stuff. Very exciting, nothing in shield. Magic, we get air magic. But again, no attunement. Nothing in any of these. Nothing in any of those. Get the standard life. We get less sun than what the other characters do. We're only level 5 in the sun. But we do get some heightened awareness, which will level up as we carry on. And we get subterfuge trained dexterity. And healthy, but we don't get trained strength like the paladin character does. And we do get 11 in tame creature, which could be interesting. Anyway, let's find this practice dummy. KZ Muppet. Let's attack, right. And you see we're already going through. Look at all those arrows we've got through. So yes, we then return to talk to Edward the Wanderer. Alright, so he'll take the long way around while we distract those skeletons. Aren't we handy for him? So my plan here is to do this little scene. Now, well, there's some dead bodies. I'm going to steal all the gold. Ooh, Quincy's broken sword. Letter from Quincy. Right. Remember that, because that's handy. That is. Are there any other dead bodies around that we need to look at? No, the gate's shut while we're doing that. So, important tip, pick that up. Let's loot these bodies for a bit of gold. It's always handy. And let's attack this skeleton. Do Air's Embrace and hope we can kill him. Bit of a dodge. I wrote my victory in my journal. Is he dead? Yes. Let's take all his gold. Take all your gold. Go on, attack the skeleton. Yeah, we killed another one. So already I'm down to 36 arrows from the 60 I started with. Which you can see is the... can I look at any of that? No. And once you're out of arrows, because you've not got any other weapons. Well, we've got 97 gold, which is not so bad. There's a soldier. Let's give it an aim shot. There we go. Once you're out of arrows, you basically can't do anything. You are somewhat ineffectual. Because because none of your starting skills actually have can do any damage. Your magical ones. So, you know, not much good to you. Right, let's go and talk to Edvard. Odd fellow, elves, boat. I'll receive 3 items from Edvard. It should be, oopsie, should be a letter. Letter for Stanley. Edward's notes on Solace Bridge, which we must give to Stanley. Excellent. Which is the start of the Love quest line, which is implemented in several, you know, you can actually go along. There are achievements for it in all sorts. So unlike the other quest lines which you've seen in the first part of this video, you can actually do some of that. And I will go and do some of it now, so you can see it. So let's head to Solace Bridge. Now I've been somewhat trepidatious to talk through the area transitions, because this release seems very crashy. Whenever I change area, there seems to be a pretty good chance of it all just disappearing. So there will be a slight pause in my jabbering while I wait to see if it crashes or not, to make editing for myself easier later on. Right, here we are in Soul Town. So let's talk to the guard, who we expect is Stanley. We're going to tell him our name, like we did all those other ones. So I've got it here somewhere. There we go. Edvard. Let's hope it doesn't go horribly wrong here. Edvard's notes on Solace Bridge. Give items. So now he tells us... there's a camp across the way, survives from the attack, all that stuff you've probably seen before. So let's leave that. So the camp's over there. What I'm going to do first is head into town and make use of the benefits of my multiple character creations and deletions over the last couple of days. So I've been experimenting with all of this. So I recommend also you follow this pattern, especially if you're going to do Ranger. The other ones, it's not so, it doesn't matter. If you're going to do Ranger, just create the character, come in here, go to the bank, which is in here, and drop off your starting gear at the bank, and then delete your character and have another go. I also bought a whole bunch of arrows while I was doing all that. So now I have arrows up the wazoo. I also have special arrows. I think there is some other flare arrow, that's the other one. Flare arrow, let's go for it. And then I have some valuable stuff, like focus potions. These are all the characters I've created. You know, there's no point in you doing that sort of thing. Fabric scrap. I do want the cure plague potion. Right, are we done? I don't want that. I don't think I want any of the rest of that stuff at the moment, unless it's valuable. Is it valuable? Oh, rusty short swords. Because I'm going to go sell it right now. Raw cotton. That's an elven bow. And an animal hide. Right. So I'm encumbered. So that's the bank. I'm now encumbered. Oh, not too bad either. But what I'm going to do is head up now to the blacksmith dude. No, dudette rather. Sell from inventory. All of that stuff. I'm no longer encumbered. There's a merchant in here if you want to buy stuff. I'm going to be selling stuff. Animal hide. Exoplasmic residue, raw cotton. See that exoplasmic residue stuff, very valuable. So now I've got 400 gold. So time to head to the skills trainer and unlock some stuff. So let's just review. I can't unlock anything here yet because I'm not up to 10. I'm going to unlock Distract so that I can start using it. I'm going to unlock Train Strength so I can start using it. I'm going to unlock Flame Fist. And is there anything I want here? Let's do the innate swiftness thing. So I think I spent all my money now. Yep. I love those fire elementals. They're so cool. So now we just need to drop some of my newfound skills into some of these things. So let's put Distract in with these two. Have I got anything else? Let's stick Flame Fist in with all of these. That looks good. So now let's head back to that camp. Oh no, before we head back to camp, this bloke. This is one of the most valuable early missions. He needs our help. And what he wants us to do is take the fight to the dead. And it's a bit laggy here. He gives us Cure Plague Potion. So while we're here nearby, I'll just get my Cure Plague Potion and place it on. Where is it? Around here somewhere. Place it on my action bar so I can use it. As you can see, I'm potioning up the wazoo at this point. They're not that useful in combat though, because they tend to be on very slow timers. Anyway, let's head to the bank. Not the bank, the camp. Let's head to the camp, where we pick up basically all the side missions. So if we go up here, so the first person you meet is a cat lady here. He gives us some bark bread, which is really kind of it. But she herself doesn't want any help because she has her nice cats. You can actually talk to her about all of her cats individually. It's really sweet. I'm not going to do that right now. And if we head over here, who's this bloke? Tell him my name. Now he wants iron blades, which you're not going to find until you're a bit higher level. They're way up the they're in higher level area up the road somewhere. So not much use to you, Emily. She's worried about Quincy. So here, come on, give us the quest completion thing. She's looking for Quincy's broken sword and letter from Emily to Quincy. So that was her letter. And Quincy's broken sword, there it is. So because we stopped to loot that soldier, here, take this, I need it not. So I presume she's given us something. No. Alright, so possibly that's broken. But we completed the quest because we stopped to loot the body. I've still got my sword equipped. Not my sword, my thing. And then if we head over this way, this lady I don't think wants any help. Adventure. The whole family's dead. Emily is looking for something though. This dude is just depressed. You can ask him his name, but generally he's not happy to see you at all. And then this woman over here, Abigail, is full of worry. Her daughter. Come on, there we go. Right, I wrote this in my journal. Goodbye. So I want to head to Solace Bridge anyway. Let's look at my current tasks. I want to head to Solace Bridge because Ashton will pay me for killing zombies. Abigail wants us to find her daughter in Solace Bridge, and then we've got that quest, which is no good to us right now. Now I just want to find Stanley and make sure we've got everything picked up from him. help. There we go. Now I've got that one as well. I think. Let's just check. No. I'm looking for him to give us a letter at this point. Oh, I could use courier, that's what we need. Right, I've got the letter from Stanley. Cool. Goodbye. So, we're going to head to Solace Bridge, kill some zombies, come back. Oh, hopefully meet that woman's daughter. Come back, collect the gold for killing the zombies. And then go and do the go and complete the first part of the love quest line, for which I need that letter from Stanley for Captain Cudjoe. So we'll just wait for this load, hope it doesn't crash. Looking good. So right, Solace Bridge we want to head towards. Not a complicated route. We enter Solace Bridge. And again, we hope it doesn't crash. So we need to kill 5 zombies and we need to talk to Charlotte Grey. Now, talking to Charlotte Grey will probably involve a lot of dying. But all we need to do is talk to her, so I will have a quick go at that. Oh, we can harvest some cotton, look. Nothing like leveling up our crafting skills. There we go, right. Awoken zombie, where is he? Over there. Can anyone see the woken zombie? Ah. I'm leveling up in stuff. Ooh, I can do a thing. Cool. Let's distract. Okay, didn't really do anything. Zombies back. Now we have got a zombie plague at this point. I think he might be dead now. Right. Let's take all that ectoplasmic residue. Let's cure ourselves of the plague. Because I've got a bunch of spare potions. Now there's another zombie around here somewhere. Is that him? Oh yes, there he is. Right. Didn't really fall for that whole distract thing, did he? And no, I see that took us off the old focus. So I'm trying to kill this one without getting the zombie plague. Is he dead? Yes. So that's two zombies down. Low level zombie obviously didn't have the ectoplasmic residue. So in here we've also got some pumpkins. You can harvest, make pumpkin pie with. I'm not going to bother at the minute. We're looking for more zombies. There's one. Let's dexterize ourselves. We killed him. Yeah, there we go. Three zombies. Oh, there's one here somewhere. It's not over this way. Is he outside? No, it must be inside then. Where's this zombie at? Let's have a quick run around here. See if he's hiding. No. No sign of the zombie. Well, there'll be some more around somewhere. Three we've killed. Here's Edward the Wanderer. Odd fell in the ruins, child companion. Ah. So what I'm not sure about is if that counts as finding out about the woman's daughter. I don't think it does. But then I ran into a weird input bug. Which meant that I couldn't actually talk to anybody. Oh, there's a zombie. Can't attack the zombie. I didn't stay distracted very long, did I? Oh, now I'm getting attacked by a wolf as well. I think I killed the zombie. Alright. Heal, please. I'm dead. Which I thought would happen. But hopefully I've distracted everyone away from the ruins. Let's see. I can dive into the ruins and chat to the girl with a little description. Oopsie. There we go. Good. Goodbye. Oh, I'm dead again. Unfortunately, there's a revival thing just outside. So now I can leg it back up to the thing. Ah, let's try attacking these grey walls. So let's see if we can pick off that zombie. Now that it's finished up, let's do that again. I like that one. I'll kill it. Oh no, it's come back to life. Set fire to it. I think I killed it that time. I think that might be 5. I'll write that victory in my journal, let's just check. There we go, I've slayed all the awakened dead required. Handy. Loot this one. There we go. I'll not bother curing myself of the plague just yet. I'm legging it from the skeletons. Let's try taking him on then. Oh, he ran away. Chicken. So, we've been in SotA, we've completed 2 side missions. One of those side missions will actually pay pretty well, as you'll see in a minute. Just going to leg it back to Soul Town now. There's another zombie here. Oh, where's the thing? Oh, there we go. Come on. Another zombie, yes. Another one outside. That's how we go at him as well. Distracting him. fire. I want to take a focus potion. No, I can't. Anyway. Oh, successful. All successful combat stuff. I'm leveling some things up, although not to the point where I can actually unlock new skills at this point. But anyway, right. Let's just remove the zombie plague. Although it will get removed when I leave the area, right? So really that's just a waste of expensive potion. But you know how it is. So I'll head back to Soul Town. We'll complete those two quests, and then I'll just go and complete the first step on the love story trail and wrap up the video. So hopefully it won't be too long by then. I've edited in the other starting area bits. It's quite busy around this area Sunday night. I presume a lot of people in America are whiling away their Sunday evening in Shroud of the Avatar. Well, it's not crashed so far. Will this be the moment? No. We're having a bit of a good run. Come on then. Into Soul Town we go. Right, so what I'll do is I'll come to the camp on the way back out and head into town and try to not get lost. I often see, until everybody builds houses around here, it's fairly straightforward, you just follow the lights. But once everyone has built houses, then there's lights all over the shop. And I keep heading towards a light that I think isn't the road, and it's actually just a light on some person's garden. It's no good to me. So here's Ashton. Hello, Ashton. I received 750 gold and I learned to perform Dance 3, the zombie dance. How cool is that? Help us blend in. Oh, goodbye. I spelt that wrong, didn't I? So you can see, now I'm loaded. Which is handy. Just nip over to the skills trainer. See if there's anything worth leveling up while I'm here. Parry, not really. Defensive stance, not really. Reckless stance, not really. Armor preservation, yeah, let's learn that. Subterfuge. Trip. I don't think that's going to be any good for the ranged weapon. Oh, look at that. Let's unlock trip and camouflage. Magic front, focus. I can't do anything with focus at the minute. Can't do anything there at the minute. Learn these ones. Let's be air attuned. Good. Is there anything worth grabbing in range combat? Oh, let's get the ammo scavenger thing so we use less arrows. Cool. So I think I've used up a lot of my gold now. But I have a good chance of improving everything later on. Now, before we leave Soul Town, let's visit the town crier. So this is a handy tip. In order to get gold early in the game. Alright, mail package for Slania. Come and ask the town crier for mail. You get 75 gold for delivering the mail. Which is a handy amount of cash. I was hoping he would give us Ardoris as a destination, but no. No. Not so lucky. Hang on, I'm heading the wrong way again. There we go. So I'm not going to head to Slania tonight. We're going to head to Ardoris, the City of Love. Unsurprisingly, since we're on the Love questline. First I'm going to nip back to the camp and tell this woman about her daughter. There's Stanley the guard. There's Abigail. Hello. Worry. So we just need to trigger the trap. There we go. Happy news. Johan's her husband. She's very delighted about Johan. He's off gathering wood. So there we go. Check the journal. Look at current tasks. We've got the mail. Got to see the guard. And Jeff and his iron blade. So, yeah, I'm a bit disappointed the mail wasn't for Ardoris. Quite often is, to be honest. But anyway, let's head to Ardoris. Let's complete the first part of the quest, for which, when you're doing it, you will actually get an achievement. Woohoo! An achievement for doing, for delivering Stanley's message. Oh, it's raining, look. So, we want to head in this general direction. Hopefully we won't get pulled into any random encounters at this point. Well, not that we couldn't cope with my vast supply of arrows from deleting the character multiple times, but... Oh, there we go. Something has caught my attention. It probably won't be very interesting then. Let's see... Sheep. I don't like that one at all. It's well boring. You've got sheep dogs that look suspiciously like wolves, and you kill the sheep dogs and harvest sheep. And I'm not sure why I would want to do that, really. Why would you want to do that? Why would you want to attack somebody's sheep just because you happen to have come across them on the road? Seems fairly scummy behaviour to me. But maybe that's the only way to get wool or something. I don't know. Where are we? Facing in some random direction on the road. There we go. Ugh. Blur my neck. I don't care. I really do not care about whatever it is that's caught my attention. Yeah, still we have to wait for it to load up. It's a pack of wolves. Go on then. Let's try for distraction. No. Do a bit of healing. Alright, we killed a wolf. He's attacking me now. Oh, blimmin' heck. More wolves. Come on then, attack him. Go over there. Alright, we kill some wolves. We kill some wolves, we leveled up in some things. It was still a bit of a waste of time because, you know, why does it matter at this point? I was just trying to show you how to complete the quest. So back into Novia. I'm facing a random direction again. Let's get into Ardris. There we go. Get into Ardris and go and complete the mission. Do 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 do. Any second now. Right, I'm going to use the boatman to get across Ardris because the bloke we need to speak to is near the docks, so that's essentially the opposite side of Ardris from where we're going to enter. Hopefully it's not going to crash at this point. Ardris is always a bit sticky. They did improve the performance a lot in the last release, made it so it is feasible to get into it even on a lower performing system, but we'll see. Maybe it'll crash now. I don't know. Come on. Oh, we're in. We're in. We're going in. Here we go. All the way. Right, so what we're looking for, right, there's Matt Cawthon. I presume, struggling with issues of the Wheel of Time. Let's go and talk to the bowman and ask him to take us to the docks. I can roll at the docks, there we go. Any second now. There we go. So in the docks. We're lagging pretty badly. I'm gonna go around here. Up here. And into this house here. And look, here's an Ardris Guard Commander. And we'll chat to Ardris Guard Commander and give him a letter from Stanley. And he still wants a letter from Stanley. I've given him one already. So, good capture Stanley request aid for Soul Town. Your next step should be to consult the powers that be in this town, specifically Lord Sorrento, Lady Kazi, and of course the Oracle. So, that's the next steps of the mission. If you're doing this and you're following along, you will at this point have got an achievement for the first phase of the Love Path missions. So I will end the video there. Hopefully you came across some useful tips in all that lot. Why does it always default to combat after the thing? I don't know. Some useful tips in that lot. I hope and help you get started playing Shroud of the Avatar.